Here at D News, we're obsessed with Mars, and we kind of think you are too. We kind of think everyone is. Ever since the Romans named the planet after their god of war, it's been used in fantastical tales in literature, radio, TV, and film. Gulliver traveled there, men are supposedly from there, and the term Martian is inspired by the planet's name. So why are we so obsessed? Well, maybe Neil deGrasse Tyson said it best. So much of what drives cosmic exploration involves the quest to learn whether or not we're alone in the universe. And though there have been some significant advances in the race to Mars, as of today, we really only have some pictures of the planet and a limited amount of data from rock samples. So some could say we really haven't gotten that far. But I'm already getting ahead of myself. Let's rewind back. In the 60s, there was a good handful of attempts to see Mars. Now, I say attempts because they pretty much all failed until Mariner 4 in 1965. The spacecraft spent just 25 minutes flying by Mars, but in that time it took 21 pictures, like this one. For the next 20 years, there were more missions to Mars and thousands of more pictures, but also a significant number of failures. Expensive failures. After losing communication with the Mars Observer in 1993, a spacecraft costing an estimated $813 million, NASA decided enough was enough. In NASA's own words, "We've tried to do too much too fast. We've lost sight of how difficult space exploration is. We've had too many mission failures which must be fixed." And that fix turned out to be something called FBC, which doesn't really need any complex scientific explanation. It's simple: faster, better, cheaper. And with that kind of mentality, NASA developed a method called aerobraking, or using the friction of another planet's atmosphere to control a spacecraft's orbit, which has saved lots of money and fuel. Aerobraking is used with the more recent Mars Odyssey and Reconnaissance Orbiter, which has played a big part in learning about the existence of water on Mars. Since then, the rover Curiosity has been our primary source for collecting data on the mysterious red planet. Curiosity is using some pretty cool tools to test rock samples, which actually tells us quite a lot. For example, the Curiosity can cook Martian rock up to 1800 degrees Fahrenheit. Depending on what temperature the sample breaks down, we can determine what compounds exist in Mars' surface. While Curiosity is still chugging along on Mars, here on Earth, NASA is planning a new mission called InSight, a lander designed to study the interior structure of Mars. Of course, it really wouldn't be a race without competitors. Big players like China are hoping to send a rover to Mars, and Russia is looking to send trained monkeys there. But there are also smaller organizations in the running, like nonprofit Inspiration Mars, who are working to send a middle-aged couple to fly by the red planet, or Elon Musk's organization SpaceX, who hope to pioneer round trips to Mars via reusable spacecrafts. And then there's the highly controversial Mars One, which has big plans to establish a permanent human settlement. But this race is a costly one, not just in terms of the billions of dollars that these projects need to get off the ground, but also the time and manpower that is required. Perhaps those involved in the race to Mars can work faster, better, and cheaper through collaboration. Maybe the key to finally finding Martians is doing a better job of working together as Earthlings. So we get to talk about stories of space exploration because of our sponsor, Toyota. They want to get the word out about their new Toyota RAV4 Hybrid. The all-new Toyota RAV4 Hybrid lets your sense of wonder lead the way and drive your passions further. How far will you take the all-new RAV4 Hybrid? And NASA's Reconnaissance Orbiter recently found strong evidence that suggests liquid water flows on Mars. Want to know more? Check out this video.
We found water on Mars! There's water on Mars! Ah!
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.